I've had a couple of people just reach out and ask for specific advice on training for the ultra marathon. And with a little bit of apprehension, I've sort of just kept my mouth closed until I've spoken to a few people who know better. But I thought it might just be nice for them to hear from a bloke like yourself. Just if you had a few just practical little tips or hints for people who have a relatively solid foundation in distance running, might be new to it, but are looking at building up to well above the marathon. Like, are there a few key points that you would recommend that they focus on in that build-up?
Yeah, that's a great question. I like that you positioned it with someone who's got experience, because I think that's a little bit experience in running anyway, because sometimes that's a little bit of a tricky question to answer without the context there. Because now the sport's gotten popular enough where you see people getting right into it without a running background, which is incredibly inspiring to see. But also, you know, you have to be a little different in your programming for them. But if someone who's got like a history in sport for running, and they're just looking to move up in distance, I think, yeah, I mean, they should definitely lean on their experience as to like kind of how they adopt to specific workouts. So, you know, I think we're learning a lot more about this too, just in the general running community, is that, you know, we get people that are like, respond really well to speed work, and they can just tolerate a higher volume of that. But if you start ratcheting up their volume and stuff like that, that's where they start to fade out, or they start to get injuries and things like that. And then you get other people on the other end of the spectrum where you give them a couple speed workouts a week and they're going to turn up injured the next day. But they can seem to run all day long and really, really hammer that mileage. So if you know that about yourself, like one way or the other, and most people are going to probably be like a decent blend between the two, they won't be so polarizing, is just kind of recognize that sort of stuff. So as you are putting these workouts and things into strategies into place, that you kind of have a realistic approach that's not going to turn you up injured and kind of ruin your race day. So once you kind of know that, I think it's just an order of operations. So like, you pick a race, if you pick like a 100 miler, you want to think of like, what's the intensity you plan on averaging for that? And then kind of be working towards that, kind of like I described earlier on, with like doing some of the least specific stuff early and the most specific stuff at the end, and then working towards that throughout. I think specificity of the terrain you're going to race on is a pretty big component, if you can get it. Obviously, if you're doing like a really mountainous technical course, you may not have that option in training as readily as someone who lives out that way. But if you have access to the terrain you're going to race in, try to get on that quite a bit, especially for your long runs if you can help it. And then I think just like consistency within whatever program you are going to follow, I like to call it micro stressing. Cause I think a lot of times people, when they think of ultra marathon, they think go big or go home, and they end up doing so much on any one or two given days that they need the rest of the week to really recover. And then they leave a few future workouts on, they lose a couple future workouts that would have amounted into overall more volume or overall more, stimulus at the given system they're trying to target. So like, I like to say, like, if you're doing like a speed workout, don't be so hung up on like going to the well on that. Like, make sure you're leaving a rep or two in the tank so that you stress yourself enough to make an improvement, but also can get away with as little recovery time as necessary to be able to get back and do another one. And then usually what I find with that is people end up spending more volume at whatever intensity they're training at when they do it that way, just because they're not spending as much time on the couch getting back to normal after a brutal workout. So yeah, that consistency, micro stressing, specificity to the distance and intensity that you're racing, kind of working from least specific to most specific, is some of the kind of like general points that I like to start people out with.